When I first heard the wolf pack call us, I immediately think, like, something went wrong. First thing that comes through my mind is, I hope Dad's okay. He has his ups and downs and has for forever. I'm pretty worried, to be honest.
Dad's health doesn't seem to be going up. It just seems to be going down. So I'm definitely a little concerned. With him feeling so bad lately, of course, you always think the worst.
It's as loud as she gets. Hello?
Hello?
Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can. How you guys doing? Can y'all hear me okay?
Yeah, we can hear you loud and clear. How are y'all guys doing? We're doing good.
Something's come up that I want to talk to you about. I heard about the integrity. I heard it's up for sale, guys. And guess where it is?
Where?
Medina Harbor.
What?
Are you serious?
The Browns' former boat, the Integrity, was abandoned and relocated to Hoonah.
The Integrity is for sale in Hoonah?
That's what I hear, and I hear the guy really has to get rid of it. He's in a bind.
Now, the local harbor master is hoping to part with the vessel and willing to strike a rock-bottom deal.
The Integrity is in town. Honestly, like, my mind is blown.
Awesome, reminds me of the old days, man.
I never thought that I would see the Integrity again.
Brown Town, dead ahead.
The Integrity has so many great memories. Just going to the open ocean, fishing, laughing with the family.
When I mentioned it to Mom, you should have seen her eyes light up. I thought she was going to float up in the air. She was so tickled to death.
This is just too good an opportunity not to check out. This boat changed our entire world. I think it's really a no-brainer. I think it's a win-win for everyone.
I want you to find it, okay? You're gonna have to really check it out good, okay?
Yeah,
right,
okay.
Gotcha,
yeah,
roger
that.
Roger that.
True.
You get the boat where it's secured, stay there in Hoonah for the winter. Don't worry about moving it or anything, and we can go back later and work on whatever we need to.
If Dad knew about the storms, I know he would want us to call it early, but the Integrity, we gave it away a long time ago, and for it to just circle back and be where we are even, I think we have to get it.
Securing the Integrity might lift Dad's spirits, knowing that there is a beacon of hope out there.
Guys,
yeah.
Take care of each other. More.
We will. More.
More.
A second winter storm is only days away from Southeast Alaska. But instead of returning back home to Washington, the Brown siblings are taking a risk.
No. Too small.
Yeah, that
too small.
Looks like the opal.
Hoping to examine and secure their old boat before the incoming snow traps them in Alaska.
Dad's tasked us with a couple things before we leave Alaska. He wants us to check out the Integrity. He wants us to make sure that she's still good and ship shape. And then he wants us to find someone that can watch it until we can come back and get it. But we're just running out of time.
I mean, this one's encased.
But yeah, way too wide.
Definitely
not.
Yeah.
Guys, look, come here. Got the small hatch door. It's either her or her sister ship.
Guys, the bow still says Integrity.
What?
Oh, is the?
Are you
like,
serious?
Make it into the
this
light.
Is her, guys.
That's
we found
the
her. It's the Integrity.
It's almost like being in some kind of alternate reality, seeing the Integrity the way that it looks now. It looks so vastly different from when we last saw it.
Very red.
Red is my particular favorite color, and even I wouldn't have painted the Integrity like she's painted now. But all in all, it's still good to see the Integrity, even if she has a bad paint job.
Permission to come aboard, Integrity?
Despite the differences of the Integrity, it still feels like it's ours.
Very different.
Oh my gosh.
It feels like stepping onto it is like coming home.
Breakfast is almost ready.
Smells good.
Thank you.
It does bring back a lot of memories, and it makes me miss Mom and Dad a lot.
Come here.
Because they've really been on it without Mom and Dad. It
smells like bow. It's wet. Man, I miss it.
It's a little toasty.
Well, the engine room's not too different.
Buying the Integrity is a slight bit of a risk. We haven't even seen the Integrity for some time. I must admit, I'm a little concerned it might take a lot of work.
Well, I'm not a mechanic, but theoretically speaking, it all looks in place. Plumbing pipes, the hydraulic hoses. It needs to be bailed. Get a little water down there.
But it's actually a pretty good leak she has. She's got a couple rotten boards on the outside and has a bit of a leak down below. But it shouldn't be too much of a problem right now. We can fix it in the future. We just need to really keep an eye on it.
All in all, most of the things that we've seen that are wrong with it is just purely cosmetic.
No, I agree 100%.
So do y'all think get her?
I think that we should. I think we're gonna be able to report back to Dad, and I think we're gonna pick this boat up.
Let's do it. Right.
Love it.
After securing a barter, the siblings take the Integrity back to Browntown to retrieve their boards of red cedar.
Well, and as new as piloting the Integrity by ourselves is, this is what Mom and Dad have always trained us for. You know, when Dad would take me up into the wheelhouse and show me how to run the boat, this is what was in his plan.
Let's have fun and make Mom and Dad proud.
Sounds like a plan, guys.
Yep.
Let's do this.
I'm a little bit nervous to see how the Integrity will fare. I've never run the Integrity by myself before.
We ready to cut? Let's do it. On three. One, two, three.
We're loose.
Everybody's on?
Yeah, we're all aboard.
Dad's really trusting me to be the one to pilot the boat, so I'm a little bit nervous that I might mess something up.
How are we doing?
Totally fine. I'm totally not thinking about if I hit an iceberg and we all die.
Sea lions. I want to come play with you, sea lions.
We can play with them later, eh? Yeah, very cute, bro, but let's stay vigilant.
The Browns are racing to secure the Integrity before an incoming blizzard threatens to lock them in Alaska.
If you remember, there's some really bad spots out here on the side.
And on their 60-foot Woodhull sub-chaser, Sister Rain leads the way back to Browntown to gather their load of wood.
Do y'all remember when we first came onto the Integrity?
I do. I remember Dad was joking with Mom about us that we just got the small, little tiny boat, but we'll make it work. And then Dad's like, ta-da! I remember everything we did with this, that cabin, the Gabe's cabin that we hauled.
Yep.
We used the Gabe's Integrity.
Cabin.
Yeah, I know.
Do you remember the cake that made that hole? That wouldn't fit through the door, so we literally had to mutilate somebody's wedding cake, chop it into little bitty pieces, and then before we gave it back to them, we had to, like,
we just pieced it back together.
It was a big cake.
We're coming up on a little bit of a dangerous part, so we're gonna have to just go very slow, make sure to keep your eyes out.
It's always a concern passing through a certain area. It's like a midway reef. And even experienced pilots like my dad keep their eyes really peeled when going through this area.
While rough waters are typically one of the biggest concerns traversing the Alaskan seas, the shallow Midway Reef is known for its unpredictably jagged terrain that could easily sink the most sturdy of ships.
You want to go a little more starboard? We're getting pretty close to that one up there.
I don't think this is working.
Just keep it down the middle. Down the middle.
Well, my thing is not working. The Integrity's navigation devices seem to be a little bit broken. Can't really captain a boat without knowing what's underneath you.
The starboard side, there's quite a bit of reefs, especially if we get closer to this thing here.
Yep, I'm turning. I see it. Hold on. I'm going to speed up a little.
Okay, go ahead.
We're on the straight and narrow now.
Good job. Keep her steady. You got it.
No, yeah, she actually looks good.
Everything looks good, Captain Rainey.
It looks like we made it through.
Dad'd be like, good job, baby girl. You brought the boat in.
Every time I think to do something, I don't hear it in my voice. I hear it in Dad's.
What's he saying?
That I got it. I'm very proud of myself for making it through the Midway Reef.
Under that and around the corner is Pelican. Would you drive us to Pelican?
What? Okay. I didn't let Dad down, and hopefully he'll be proud of me too once he hears about it. Being back in Alaska has taught me a lot. I do definitely feel like I have a newfound sense of freedom, and hopefully I can contribute that back home.